I always see you described as a brilliant musician with a manner that is invariably referred to as, their adjectives are imperious, you know, formal. I think people are used to you seeing you in a, you know, certainly in the concert setting. And then I see you here in jeans, right? And a much more relaxed person than I think people are familiar with. Is this you, or is this a way of letting down your hair?
I'm afraid
hair,
it's,
so to speak?
It's me.
This is you.
Yeah, what folks, for whatever reason, out there define me as is their problem, not mine. I know who I am, and if you use that word imperious to my kids, they would just laugh you off the property, because that's just not me. Mm-hmm. And so I suppose when I was younger, when I was much younger, being a young conductor in a world where only older people were accepted, I probably, like all young people, tried to make myself more important and to seem the kind of person that folks ought to take me more seriously. But that's a long time ago. And since then, now with, you know, the fact that I'm 40 years older than everybody instead of 20 years younger obviously has its effect on my personality, I guess.
I also saw that you're going to take up a new directorship in Munich in September.
That's
at
right.
At age 82.
That's right.
So you are not in any way slowing down.
No. And then, you know, I have developed lots of musical friends along the way. There's the Vienna Philharmonic. I just celebrated a 50-year anniversary with them of musical interaction, 11 New Year's concerts televised live from Vienna, 500 concerts, and so forth and so on. But next year I'm going back to the New York Philharmonic, which I love. I was there as 7 years as visitor director. I'll be there for 2 weeks. I'm going back to the Met. I love the Met. I first conducted there in 1961. That's a long time ago, too. And I'm so looking forward to this Don Carlos series. It's an opera I adore. So I'll be not only in Munich, but, you know, not forgetting my old friends and going to visit them. They would like me to come back. Obviously, I wouldn't dream of imposing myself upon them. But they seem to think that I can still cut the marmalade. So... until such time that that is no longer true, I'll be going about the world, also in the Far East. And I'll be going back to Russia, where I haven't been in I don't know, long time.
All right, now I do want to ask you one more question about where, before the camera started, we were talking about conducting. What you've learned about how one leads. You were saying that one actually has to learn to follow first, and then to learn to lead people.
Well, as a conductor, I feel that I was extremely fortunate in coming from a family that had no means, which obliged me to earn my own living in order to put myself through college, right? So I joined the Pittsburgh Symphony at the age of 18, being a very good fiddler, and put myself through night school. I earned money during the day and went to night school until at midnight every day. And in the process of which, I found myself having to learn how to follow. And it was an interregnum in Pittsburgh between music directors, 3 years, and we had the world's most famous guest conductors. And I learned my craft at the other end of other people's batons.
I see.
And I became a very, very good follower. And then I had years as first violin of a string quartet. And there's interaction with your colleagues. It's not quite sure who's following whom, and nor should one know, even though the first violin is obviously theoretically in a leading position. So all this experience taught me how to follow, and then I put all of this to use later on, and I could also understand the psychology of those who follow, what it is that an orchestra musician wants really to have from a conductor. The two very, very simplistic sounding rules, but very important. Conductors are there to conduct, not to make speeches. And two, they are there to give a beat that everybody can understand. It's as simple as that.
So don't waste time with speeches and keep time for the music.
That's right. No choreography. Just do your job. Functional mm-hmm. conducting. Obviously, there's a lot more to conducting and making music than that. But these are two points that I learned as a player. You know, when a conductor finally would appear on the podium who knew where the downbeat is and could communicate with clarity just what it is that he expected from each player, musically and technically, it was just like heaven.